We're about to get into today's Cleveland Browns mailbag. Before we do that, I'm trying to make the Browns Report a full-time channel here at Chat Sports. But in order to do that, you guys need to subscribe. Hit that big red button. It's youtube.com/BrownsReport. The more subscribers that we get, it's pretty simple here at Chat Sports. The more videos we can do for you guys, and maybe even do them every single day. First up on the mailbag, Corey Decker just says, trade OBJ for Julio. Unsurprising, there are actually quite a few Julio Jones ones, but I limited it just to the one question. I get it. It is Julio Jones. And if we're being honest here, Odell Beckham in his time in Cleveland hasn't lived up to expectations. The unreal one-handed catch machine, arguably best receiver in the NFL, hasn't been the guy we've seen a lot in Cleveland. And if you wanted to get Julio Jones, moving OBJ is one way to do it. But Julio's also older. He's also coming off injury problems. So even though I get the appeal of Julio Jones, I think I'd actually move Jarvis Landry before I moved Odell Beckham, and I don't know if I want to tinker too much with an offense that I think bringing back Odell Beckham is going to be really good. So what do you guys think here? We are a show for the people, after all. Pick a wide receiver. Type OBJ for you'd rather have Odell Beckham on your roster, or type in JJ for you'd rather get Julio Jones. Let me know what you guys are thinking in the comments section. Let's go to Will Larrick now. We had some questions from YouTube and Twitter on today's show. Had the Browns just gone from a bottom five secondary to a top five secondary? I'm actually very intrigued by this. The overhaul the Browns made in the back end is significant. Now, at the same time, injuries just destroyed that secondary last year. I mean, you look at what they're probably going to start. No disrespect to Ronnie Harrison. Again, they'll use a lot of three safety looks. Denzel Ward, Greedy Williams, Grant Delpit are all back in the end. And those guys were all banged up, at least in some capacity last year. Troy Hill, John Johnson, I love those additions. You add Greg Newsome in the first round. You still have Ronnie Harrison on top of that. I think this Browns secondary is significantly improved. Now, will it be top five? I think depth and talent-wise, you can make that argument. A lot of it, though, will come down to the health going forward. So we will see what things look like from the Browns' perspective on that one. From Peter, I got faith in Curtis Weaver and Takk McKinley. One of them will be the long-term answer to play opposite Myles Garrett. I love the optimism there. I don't know if that's really going to end up being the case. One bright side here is the Browns haven't committed too much to those guys, so if they do, awesome. If not, not the end of the world. We all know Myles Garrett is one of the best edge rushers in the entire NFL, and Jadeveon Clowney will play a key role. Now, Takk McKinley, especially for where he was drafted, has been a pretty significant disappointment. I liked Curtis Weaver a lot coming out of Boise State. So I'm glad to hear that you got faith on that one, Peter. I'm not going to assume that they are. We'll see what happens this year. If they don't make a big impact, I think next offseason, edge rusher will once again be a key need for Cleveland. Will, once again, with a fantastic question, and it's a tough one for me. Is Nick Chubb worth extending? Analytics say no, but is he a rare exception? That's a tough one, man. Even dating back to last year, we were asked, hey, who's going to be the best back in the NFL? And I'm like, after this past year, Nick Chubb's going to be in that conversation. And I think he should be. Now, he missed some time, and it nerfed his stats, but Nick Chubb is awesome. The efficiency, the ground game he offers, in terms of pure runners, he is one of the best in the NFL. However, he is going to be expensive, a lot more than what the Browns had to pay Kareem Hunt. With the way the salary cap set to explode soon, Nick Chubb, if he's healthy this year and plays like he did last year, he's going to be asking for record-setting money among running backs in the NFL. He's going to be asking for $16-plus million. And yes, the Vikings, or the Browns, once in the football, just like Kevin Stefanski did with the Vikings and Dalvin Cook, but that's a lot of money. This is not a dig at all against Nick Chubb. I think he is among the most talented backs in the NFL. It's also an quote-unquote easier position to find in the NFL. So it's a really tough question. So I will take the coward's way out here and let you guys answer for me. Do you want to pay Nick Chubb? Let's say it's $16 million on the money. What do you guys think? Do you want to pay Nick Chubb? Get your votes in for me. Type Y for yes, or you can type in N for no. An Instagram question, very rare here, from Pete. Potentially very deep and down to tight end room. First off, you can get rid of the potentially. How are they going to take advantage, especially with all the other weapons on offense? I think you will see more of the same. There will be multiple tight end looks. That is what Kevin Stefanski likes to do. Austin Hooper, David Njoku, Harrison Bryant, three very good football players. All three of them will play games and significant snaps for the Cleveland Browns. Now, whether it's tight end two or three between Njoku or Bryant doesn't matter all that much. Hooper's probably still your lead guy. I think in the end, with all of the weapons the Browns have, it will end up being a true spread-the-ball-around approach for Cleveland this season. If you guys want even more Cleveland Browns videos, subscribe right now to youtube.com/Browns Report. Link is right there on the bottom of your screen. I want to do more Browns videos. It's a meritocracy here at Chat Sports, though. So the more subscribers, the more views, and the more videos we end up doing here going forward. Our mailbag now gets into a trade idea from Nathan Wagner, who some of you might not like, but there were a lot of Aaron Rodgers-focused ones here. Now, the trade offer was Baker Mayfield, two firsts, and Greedy Williams. In the end, this comes down to, do you believe in Baker Mayfield? If the answer's no, then you go do this trade. If you think that Baker Mayfield is the franchise future, which I do for the Cleveland Browns, then you don't do it. It would also significantly shorten your window given the age of Aaron Rodgers. In the end, kind of all a moot point here. Like, I don't think the Browns are going to go get Aaron Rodgers. It's a moot point. I just don't think they're going to go do that. They're planning on Baker being the guy. The Packers even want Baker? I don't know. They should, because I don't think Jordan Love's that good. I don't expect an Aaron Rodgers trade. Because of that, I just think we're better served looking elsewhere for Cleveland. So Will Eric now, and this is a good question again, is Teller a guard worth extending, or is that still too much money to invest in the guard position? So I loved Wyatt Teller coming out of Virginia Tech, one of my wins in terms of the NFL draft scouting process. I liked him a lot more than where he ended up going. And the Browns got a steal when they got him from the Buffalo Bills. Shout out Bill Callahan for help developing that offensive line. But you've invested in Joel Bitonio, and you've also got to potentially pay Nick Chubb in the not-too-distant future. So I would like to pay Wyatt Teller, but it is a matter of, do you want to pay that much to your interior offensive line, having already paid Jack Conklin at right tackle and J.C. Treader? That's a tough question for me. And you might be in this position. You can only pay one of these guys, the running back or the really good offensive guard. It's a tough one for me. So pick one. Who would you rather pay? Type WT for Wyatt Teller or type NC for Nick Chubb. Two players I absolutely love, but you might have to choose between in the not-too-distant future. Back-to-back ones here from Will. Odds David Njoku is on this team next year. I know you mean 2022. Never say never. I'm going to go with low, and I think in Njoku, the trade demand, which he then rescinded and is going to play, I think, this year for Cleveland no matter what, I don't think he's going to be back in Cleveland. I would say the odds are pretty darn low at that point. I think in the end, he's going to go search more playing time and potentially for more money in the offseason. He's a talented player, but Harrison Bryant's on the roster. The Browns are not going to get involved in a bidding war if there is one there. And Njoku might want a chance at more snaps and targets anyway. From Steven C32, Takitaki is not starting material. Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoah will start, and so will Jacobs. So there were several questions and comments that I saw on our Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoah video when I presented this linebacker depth chart. And this was not meant to be what I would do. Because I agree with Lonnie. I don't think Sione Takitaki is all that great. I want to see Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoah starting. I want to see Jacob Phillips starting. Frankly, if you're going to use, you know, nickel linebacker sets, those are probably the two I would take. Now, Anthony Walker will play some. We'll see what Mac Wilson ends up doing. I don't like Takitaki in coverage, so I put him at strong side linebacker. Jacob Phillips, by the way, at his combine and at his, on his listed size, 6'3", 229, so not 6'4", 240, as some of you guys have said. Now, he has room to bulk up, and he very well could. I wouldn't mind that. I don't mind playing Phillips and Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoah. So what I'm saying is I was not trying to heap praise upon Sione Takitaki. He's got to be a lot better, despite how great his name is. Overall, the Browns have not invested that much at the linebacker position, and I'm a big believer in Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoah. I want him playing key snaps. What the base starters, quote-unquote, might not be your starters in terms of snap counts, and that's what matters more than anything else. So let's talk linebackers some more here. Who do you think is the very best linebacker on the Cleveland Browns? It's bold. I kind of want to go Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoah. I love that guy. I think he's going to be a stud, a perfect fit in the Browns' defensive scheme and style. But let me know what you guys think in the comments section. And we're capping off this mailbag by going full homer here. Chris Riker, how likely will the Browns be ruining Mahomes' desire to go 20-0 in week one? I say 99%. Probably not quite that high, if anything that high. I love the optimism, though. I think the Browns could surprise people. I think this Cleveland Browns team is going to be very good in 2021. I just don't know if upsetting the Chiefs in week one is the most likely outcome, but I still love the optimism.